Hi, I'm Dr. Greg Schmidt. I'm an intensive care specialist at the University of Iowa, and I'm going to talk a little bit today about face masks and carbon dioxide. In health, your oxygen saturation levels are in the 95 to 100 range. We can measure that easily with a pulse oximeter. And if you put one of those on, you'll see that your oxygen saturation level is probably about 97-98%. If you put on a mask and measure your oxygenation level, it's going to be 97-98%. Might even be 99 or 100%, but it'll be the same with a mask as without a mask. The same is true for carbon dioxide. We have ways of easily measuring the carbon dioxide levels in your blood, and those levels are in the exhaled breath 35 to 45 range, and that'll be true with a mask, and it's true without a mask. So the idea that masks somehow affect blood levels of oxygen and carbon dioxide, it's not true. An important point is that oxygen and carbon dioxide are so small that they pass easily through a face mask. Now, things are different for droplets. Droplets are bigger. Droplets can't as easily pass through a mask. So when I wear a mask, I'm somewhat protected against droplets because they get caught in the mask and may not get into me. My droplets can't as easily get out. I do find masks inconvenient. I'd rather not wear one. I like to see people's faces. I'd rather not bother with it. But I understand that the best way to not have to wear one is to wear one now and get this virus knocked down to where we can all go back to a world that may be safer and where we don't have to wear masks.